Real estate denotes a significant portion of most people's wealth. It is especially true in a country like India, where investing in real estate property is the first advice given to anyone who starts off with a stable career. According to 2011 census data, only 69% of urban households own a home. The size and scale of the real estate market makes it an attractive and lucrative sector for many investors. In this video, we will look at some of the main factors that influences the real estate market and how real estate affects the economy. So the first factor that influences the real estate is demographics. It is the data that describes the composition of a population, such as age, race, gender, income, migration patterns, and population growth. At first, it may look, oh come on, how does it matter, and it can be easily overlooked. But these statistics affect how real estate is priced and what types of properties are in demand. If there is a substantial shift in the demographics of a nation, then it can have a huge impact on real estate trends for many decades. I'll give you an example. So India got independence in 1947. The average age of a retiree today in India is roughly around 60 years. In other words, people who were born between 1945 and 1965. Now these people who were born between 1945 and 1965 has tremendous potential to influence the real estate market. The time at which they will retire, which is around 2005 to 2025, it is the most interesting generational trends in a century. Now many have retired since 2005. Their trend is an evidence for us as to how the prices of real estate has shot up in the past 10 years. And we will see this change in trend for another decade. Now if you're an investor, before investing you could ask some key questions like, what is the income level of retirees? Do they have a big family or a small family? Because that in turn will answer questions like whether they will prefer a big house or a small house. Then it will also answer the location where people can afford to buy homes. So these are some questions that can help you narrow down for a type and location of your desired property. So this was the first key factor that affects the real estate market. The second factor is the economy as a whole. Now when we think of the word economy, all these economic terms like GDP, unemployment rate, manufacturing growth, the prices of goods and services, all these things come into our mind. Because these terms are the key economic indicators that tells us about the health of the economy, whether the economy is growing or slowing down. It's a simple thing to understand. If the economy is sluggish or poor, then the real estate sector will be sluggish as well, and vice versa. Because think about it, if unemployment is high, prices of goods and materials is high, then it discourages people to invest in a property. After all, if the purchasing power is low and the cost of building a house is high, then who would like to invest in such a market condition? But then the interesting thing to notice is that there will be certain types of property in real estate that will not be affected. For example, office leases. They are a form of property that is leased for a longer period of time, and their rates cannot be changed in the middle of an economic downturn. That's why these big corporations enjoy that perk and they carry on with their work even if the economy is low. Of course, there will be a cost cutting, but then rarely we see a big corporation shutting down that often. So economy as a whole is another key factor for the real estate market. The third factor is interest rates. Now I have explained in other videos what interest rates are. Interest rates are the cost for borrowing money. When you go to a bank or any financial institution and ask for a loan, they will give you the money along with a certain interest rate based on the time period. That means you will have to return the principal amount along with interest rate. And this is the same thing with banks as well if they borrow from the central bank RBI. Now if the interest rates are high, then you will not prefer to take a loan. Therefore that decreases the money supply in the economy. Generally RBI uses this mechanism of changing the interest rates to control the money supply. That will then control inflation in the economy. Now changes in interest rates can greatly influence a person's ability to purchase a residential property. Because buying a property is not always dealt in loose cash. You will mostly apply for a mortgage. Hence, higher the interest rates, higher will be the cost to obtain a mortgage to buy a home, which will reduce the demand for real estate, which further pushes the prices down. Understand the trickle-down effect. Similarly, if the interest rates are low, lower will be the cost to obtain a mortgage to buy a home, which increases the demand for real estate, and that further pushes the prices up. So interest rates is one of the most important key factor that affects the real estate market. And the fourth factor is government policies or subsidies. Now legislation is an important factor that can have an impact on property demand and prices. Suppose the government gives subsidy. Subsidies are basically incentives. So the government gives subsidies to big businesses to open their plants and factories at a particular place, because of which business will create more output. Hence they would need required manpower. that will in turn make people reside nearer to the companies. If you look at the technology hub in a country, places like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Gurgaon, people working there tend to live nearer to the MNC companies. This makes the property rate shoot up in these areas. Another point is, suppose the government increases tax rates. So if you earn more, then you will have to pay more tax. And people want to earn more. Now, many people believe that investment in house property is a smart tax saving plan while creating an asset with a long-term view. So this is how government policies or subsidies affects the real estate market. So these were the four high-level factors that play a significant role that affects the real estate market. Although there are some more complex factors that come into play, like surrounding development of the location, where the property is, availability of civic amenities, and all those small complex things. But then these four factors gives a clear-cut relationship between the market and the demand. The purpose of this video is to give you an overall view of how these factors create a certain type of market demand for real estate sector that is so huge. I hope you found this video informative. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.